Hello. Pretty, huh? Look at that. Oh my. The sun set about 10 or 15 minutes ago. Well, that light is coming from beyond the horizon, coming up and reflecting off the bottom of the floating clouds. It's finally starting to cool a little bit. We are having a bit of a heat wave here. Fortunately, over here, only 5 miles from the ocean, it's not as bad as it is to the east of us in the inland valleys and the hills, and beyond the hills and mountains in the desert. It's up in the 100 teens, 110, 115 out in the desert. Out here, it's only in the 90s in the daytime. The temperature's dropped now. It's down in the 80s somewhere. See in the other direction, the moon is coming up. It's not full yet, it's waxing. These are the longest days of the year now. The sun is gone just about as far north as it'll go, and so here in the northern half of the earth, these are the longest days. South of the equator, South America, Africa, Australia, they're having winter down there now, coming on. The shortest days of the year for the southern hemisphere. But up here in the north, it's summer. The last days of spring are turning into summer. The solstice day comes next week on the 20th, I believe it is, this year. That'll be a couple days from now, day after tomorrow, I think it is. Yeah, Tuesday's the 21st, so day after tomorrow, Monday. Of course, by the time you see this, it'll probably be tomorrow already. Monday is the 20th. And after that, astronomically, summer has begun in the northern hemisphere of the planet Earth. I don't know if you've noticed it, but the gleaming scarlet coral colors of the sky have begun to fade now into charcoal. The Earth is turning further and further into the east, and we're leaving the sun behind. The shadow of the earth has risen up and will soon take over the whole sky, and it will be night. But I couldn't sit still without turning on the camera. It was such a beautiful color in the sky and the clouds. So magnificent just to stand here and look at that. It's a blessing. A great blessing. I am grateful to be alive. I'm grateful to have a place where I can look at such beauty as exists in our world. My, it's getting dark quicker. All that scarlet fire that was on the cloud is fading away. I didn't actually see the sun go down tonight. I've been watching it the past few days. Haven't seen the green flash. But tonight I didn't even see the sunset. I just caught the sky afterwards. It's beautiful, beautiful colored sky. In a minute, I think I'll turn the camera around and look at the moon and see if I can pick out Mars. Maybe not. There's some clouds. Hazy air. Not good seeing tonight. I've been thinking for a couple months about buying a telescope, but every time I read and study more about telescopes, I realize the seeing for the stars and the planets just isn't that good here because of all the city lights. And it's not worth going deeper into debt just to have another toy. I do believe I can see Mars now, however. It's over there. Right up over there. Gleaming in the sky, just a little tiny twinkle in the blue-gray twilight. I'm not sure how many minutes I've got coming on now. It says, fades out so quick, I can't tell. Well, anyhow, that was a beautiful scarlet cloud, trimmed in coral and gold, and now it's just fading away. Yes, it is. Good night, my friends. I'll see you soon.